Hi students, welcome back to R4C Learning YouTube class for MCET. Okay, now yesterday we learned about the concept of tangent law. Okay, and also have to give the one application, means explanation of one application based on the tangent law only. Now today also I have to give one application based on the tangent law. That means the problem which is related to the tangent law only. Okay, now what I am doing is, listen carefully, a body of mass, a body of mass, let us say root 3 kg, is suspended from a rigid support by using a string. Okay, now so what is the horizontal force? What is the horizontal force required? To make the string when a string makes an angle 60 degrees, otherwise 30 degrees also you have to take, no problem. Makes an angle 30 degrees with vertical. Okay, and also find the tension developed in the string. So this is the question which is the example for tangent law. Okay, here what I am giving the question is, a body of mass root 3 kg is suspended from rigid support by using a string. What is the horizontal force required when the string makes an angle 30 degrees? Because yesterday I have to give the one problem which is makes an angle 60 degrees. That's why here I am taking 30 degrees with vertical. And also find the tension developed in the string. Okay, that means I have to give the diagram for this one as per the tangent law only. Because we know already tangent law on yesterday class. So this is the body having mass how much? Root 3 kg. Means by the application of horizontal force, it makes an angle, let us say 30 degrees with horizontal. Now what are the forces acting on the body here? Please tell me. What kind of forces acting on the, let us say this is the tensile force. Now listen carefully. This is the downward force always mg, and this is the external horizontal force F. Now as per the resolution of vectors, what is the forces here? If it is stator, this is also 30. That means this is T cos 30. This is how much? T sin 30. Suppose if the body which is at rest means equilibrium means it follows the two equilibriums in this case, as well as that means horizontal equilibrium as well as vertical equilibrium. Horizontal equilibrium means rightward force is equal to leftward force. If it is in vertical equilibrium means upward force is equal to downward force. As per the condition of yesterday tangent law, yeah, please tell me if the body is at rest. So before going to the solution, yeah, please tell me if the body is at rest. So the body is at rest means what are the formulas here? F is equal to again P sin theta. This is we know already. This is considered again the equation number 1. Okay. And so downward force is equal to upward force as per the concept. Mg is equal to how much? P cos theta. Cos theta means here I am substituting 30 degrees because we know already theta. That means 30 degrees. Okay. This is equation number 2. So by dividing these two equations, you got the direct horizontal force means 1/2. What I am getting is, as per the yesterday concept only, Fy, external force by weight of the body, is equal to, by cancelling this tension on RHS of two equations, how much it is? Sin 30 by cos 30. Now that is F is equal to how much? Mg into tan 30. mg into tan 30. Is it clear?
Now that means here, listen carefully. Here, what I am giving the mass of the body here?
2-3 kg.
Now that means what is the horizontal force required to keep the body? Is it rest at this angle, particular angle means F is equal to mg tan 30. That means m means how much it is? Again, root 3 into g can be taken as sometimes 10. That's why here I am taking 10. Or otherwise, you have to take g is equal to 10 meter per second square. So root 3 into 10 into how much it is? Again, tan 30 means 1 by root 3. Tan 30 is 1 by root 3. So 1 by root 3 both are cancelled together. That means how much I am getting? 10 newton. 10 newtons. That means listen carefully. So by taking the tangent law, suppose if the body which is in equilibrium means
horizontal equilibrium as well as vertical equilibrium.
So by taking the two equations, like equation number one, suppose if the body is in horizontal equilibrium, right wall force is equal to left wall force, means F is equal to d sin theta and mg is equal to d cos theta. So by dividing these two equations, F by mg is equal to tan 30. That means F is equal to how much? By cross multiplying mg into tan 30. We know the value of mass m nothing but the root 3 kg and g nothing but 10. By taking this condition, g is equal to 10 meter per second square. So tan 30 is 1 by root 3 and root 3 both are cancelled together, means what is the horizontal force required in this case? 10 newton. Now at the same time, what is the tension developed in the string? What is the tension? That means after I am calculating the horizontal force, I have to find the tension also as per the equation number 2. As per this equation number 2, tension equation how much it is? Yeah. That means T is equal to how much as per the equation number 2? Mg by cos 30. Mg by cos 30. Yeah, please tell me, mg means root 3 into 10 by cos 30 means root 3 by 2. Okay, that means root 3 both are cancelled together. That means what is the answer here? 20 newtons. For example, if I am taking g is equal to 9.8, if g is equal to 9.8 I am taking, then what is the horizontal force here? 9.8. And what is the tension here? 2 into 9.8, 19.6 newtons. So this is the method to solve the horizontal force and tension developed in the string at this case.
Okay, as per the tangent law concept. Okay.
So this is about the applications of tangent law.
Okay.
Right.
Yeah, next I have to go with the Lamy's theorem. Lamy's theorem. So this is very important and it gives the condition for equilibrium. So first of all, what is the condition for equilibrium by taking the vectors? Suppose if the body is in equilibrium, means what is the sum of all forces? 0. That means listen carefully. Suppose if the body which is at rest, means I have to take the condition for equilibrium. So this is the particle of mass which is at rest. Rest means what are the forces, like here I am taking, let us say this is F1 bar, this is F2 bar, this is F3 bar, F4 bar, F5 bar. So these are the all congruent coplanar vectors which is acting on the particle of mass m. Okay, then due to the all forces, what is the net force here? Suppose the net force is equal to 0. Net force is equal to 0 means the particle is at rest or it moves with uniform velocity also sometimes. That means the resultant force acting on the particle is 0, then the body is at rest. Rest means equilibrium. Okay, for example, let us say for this I am taking, I have to take the three vectors, like, yeah, this is one vector and this is some other vector and this is some other vector. So these all vectors like F1 bar and F2 bar and this is F3 bar. So this is the condition for equilibrium only. Equilibrium. Equilibrium means rest. Okay. That means listen carefully. Suppose if any body which is at rest, means the sum of net forces acting on the body is 0. So for example, I am taking the example for equilibrium, means I have to take the three vectors which are taken in same order. That means F1 bar, F2 bar, F3 bar. These three vectors are taken in same order, means the particle which is starting from this point and again come back to the same point. Means what is the resultant vectors? 0. That means here what is the sum of these vectors here? If the particle is at rest, means F1 bar plus F2 bar plus F3 bar is equal to resultant force is equal to how much? 0. So this is the actual expression for the equilibrium. That means if the particle is in equilibrium, the net force acting on the particle is equal to 0. Right? Now, listen carefully. As per this condition, I have to take Lamy's theorem. So this is the most important. So sometimes it is nothing but the sine rule in mathematics also, in trigonometry. Okay. Now next concept is Lamy's theorem. Lami's theorem. Okay.
So what is meant by Lami's theorem? All of you listen carefully.
What I'm doing is I'm taking three forces. Like let us say this is P bar. I'm taking
one vector,
and I'm taking the other vector which is taken like this. Let us say this is Q bar, and this is the third vector I'm taking R bar.
So these are the three vectors. Three coplanar congruent. Congruent means if the vectors which are starting from the same point means the vectors are said to be congruent. Congruent means the initial point of the all vectors is same. Means the initial point of the all vectors which is coexist at a particular point, that vectors are nothing but the congruent. Coplanar means these all vectors which are taking the same plane. Okay. That means these are the three coplanar congruent vectors which is acting on a particle of mass m. Then this particle is at rest. Means equilibrium. That means the three forces I am taking, this can be taken as force, like P bar and Q bar and R bar. These are the three forces which are acting on the particle simultaneously. Then what happens? The particle is said to be at rest or equilibrium. Now listen carefully. I have to take the angles in between Q and R is like opposite angle is alpha I am taking, and in opposite to the Q bar I am taking, let us say this is beta I am taking. In opposite to R bar I am taking the angle is, let us say, gamma. Okay. That means here what happens, thus Lami's theorem is, listen carefully, it gives the condition for equilibrium. Condition for equilibrium, that means if the three coplanar congruent forces, if the three coplanar congruent forces acting on a particle or body, particle simultaneously, then the particle is in equilibrium. So this is the statement of Lami's theorem only. That means what is the meaning? The three coplanar congruent forces acting on a particle simultaneously, then the particle is in equilibrium. This is the definition. Means this is the diagram for this definition. Now listen carefully. What is the actual Lami's theorem is? So this can be redrawn. Like it. So this P bar is shifting like this. Okay, this is the P bar. Listen carefully. And this Q bar is taking like this. This is Q bar. I'm taking. And this is the R bar can be redrawn like this only. That means these are the three vectors which are in same sense. Means the sum of these three vectors are nothing but zero, as per the condition of equilibrium. Now, that means P bar plus Q bar plus R bar is equal to zero. Now listen carefully. What is the angle between here? And what is the angle between there? And what is the angle between here? Means the angle between P bar and Q bar. That means in opposite of P bar is how much angle? Alpha. That means here, listen carefully. So here I am taking, this is the alpha. So that means here the angle between Q bar and R bar is how much? Q bar and R bar is alpha as per this diagram. So here listen carefully, one vector is like this and another vector is like this. That means here what is the angle? Obtuse angle. Okay. That means listen carefully, if the head of the second vector which is added to tail of the first vector, or the tail of the second vector added to the head of the first vector, means the angle is nothing but the obtuse angle, like this is the alpha as per the diagram. Now what is the angle here? So total angle triangle means it is pi minus alpha. Now as per the same case, here what is the angle between this R bar and P bar? This is R bar, this is P bar, nothing but beta. Okay. Now here what is the angle again? This is the pi minus beta as per the triangle, because in triangle total angle is 180. Okay, now again, this is what happens to the angle between this Q bar and P bar. Here is gamma. Now what is this value? Pi minus gamma. So these are the angles which is formed by this triangle. That means like P bar, Q bar and R bar. Okay, then what is the actual statement of Lami's theorem is? The magnitude of force which is directly proportional to, that means the magnitude of vector means magnitude of P bar directly proportional to sine of opposite angle means sine of angle between the two vectors, the remaining two vectors, means how much it is? Sine of pi minus alpha. That means what is the condition here? P by
sine of pi minus alpha is equal to some constant. That means in this way we have to apply this condition for the remaining two vectors also. What is the method here? Again q by sine of pi minus beta also constant, again r by again sine of how much pi minus gamma also constant. That means by taking these three conditions, what is the final conclusion here? So this is nothing but the sine rules in mathematics. That means what I am doing is actual sine rule or Lamy's theorem can be defined as the magnitude of force, the ratio of magnitude of force to the sine of opposite angle or sine of angle between the remaining two vectors is always constant. Means let us say that is what I am doing is p by sine of how much it is pi minus alpha, which is equal to, that means magnitude of p by this opposite angle between the two vectors means how much pi minus alpha, again q by, yeah please tell me, sine of opposite angle between the q bar and r bar means q by q opposite angle how much pi minus beta. Okay, that is equal to how much r by again sine of pi minus gamma which is equal to constant. So as per the rule, that means we know already sine of pi means 180. Sine 180 minus theta is nothing but sine theta, because it is in second quadrant. Means how much it is sine of alpha, p by sine alpha is equal to, again how much it is q by sine beta is equal to, again in the similar way r by sine gamma. So this is nothing but the gamma. Okay, so this is the nothing but the sine rule or Lamy's theorem. That means if the three forces which is acting simultaneously on a particle, then this particle is in at rest. Three forces means what is the forces here? What I am taking these vectors? These are the three vectors. Coplanar concurrent vectors. Coplanar means same plane, concurrent means same point. So these are the three coplanar concurrent vectors which are acting on a particle simultaneously. Then the particle is at rest or equilibrium. Then this diagram can be represented in a triangle like this. Okay, as per the rule, the angle between the two vectors, like this is p bar, this is q bar. What is the angle between p bar and q bar? As per this case, p bar and q bar is gamma. That's why here I am taking this is gamma. As per this rule, this is pi minus gamma. Why? Because the total angle is nothing but 180. Okay, so as per this condition also, how much it is? The angle between q bar and r bar, how much? The angle between q bar and r bar, nothing but alpha. Okay, so here. So again, this is the total angle, how much? Because the total angle is pi. If it is alpha, means this is pi minus alpha as per the rule. Again, this is the angle between r bar and p bar is beta. This is nothing but pi minus beta. Then what is the actual definition of Lamy's theorem is the magnitude of force acting on the particle. The magnitude of force acting on the particle is directly proportional to sine function of the angle between the remaining two vectors. The angle between the remaining two vectors means like this one. Okay. That means here what I am taking is p by sine 180 minus alpha is equal to q by sine 180 minus beta is equal to r by sine 180 minus gamma. 180 means pi. That means what is the value here? What is the actual equation for Lamy's theorem means p by sine alpha is equal to q by sine beta is equal to r by sine gamma. Okay, this is the actual formula. Now how to apply this for formulas in physics? Means I have to give some examples for this Lamy's theorem. Okay, please all of you try to follow this concept along with me. So Lamy's theorem means simple. The three coplanar concurrent forces acting on a particle simultaneously, then the particle or body is at rest or equilibrium, simply. Okay. So this proof of reality, can be derived in mathematics also, in trigonometry, first year track 1. Okay. Now, I have to give one application based on the Lamy's theorem. The problem which is related to the Lamy's theorem. Okay, so what I am giving is, let us say, listen carefully, I have to give one diagram. So this is the particle, this body, this is the another string, here what I am giving is, let us say, 900 newtons. So this can be taken as string tension T1, this is tension T2. Let us say this can be taken as 30 degrees, this can be taken as 60 degrees. This is perpendicular. Okay, listen carefully from figure. I have to find the values of Find the values of find the values of T1 and T2. T1 and T2. This is the question. That means here what I am giving is, there existed three forces. That means the three forces like T1, T2 and 900 Newtons. These are the three forces which are acting on a particle simultaneously. Particle means what is the mass of this body? Here 900 Newtons weight given. Mg given. Means by 10, we have to divide by 10 means 90 kg. That means if the body of mass 90 kg here, then what are the forces acting on this particle means? Here let us say this is T1, this is T2 and Mg. So these are the three coplanar congruent forces. Coplanar congruent forces which is acting on the particle or body. Then this body is in equilibrium. Okay. So as per Lami's theorem, what is the formula? Please tell me. Lami's theorem equation is actually formula is P by sin alpha is equal to again Q by sin beta is equal to again R by sin gamma. Sin gamma. Okay. So this is the actual formula for Lami's theorem. Now how to apply this formula for this one? That means in place of P, I am taking this is the T1, tensile force acting on the first thing. In place of Q, I am taking let us say T2, second force. And the third force is nothing but in place of R, I am taking 900 Newtons. So as per this concept, yeah, please tell me what are the here angles as per this diagram. This is 90 degrees again. This is also 90 degrees. Okay. Now please tell me, before going to the solution, what is the method? Means P means here T1. I am applying T1 by. Yeah, sine of opposite angle of T1. So what is the opposite angle for T1 plus this is nothing 90 plus 60 means sine 150. Sine 90 plus 60 as per the diagram. That is equal to again T2 by again what is the opposite angle for this one? Yes, sine of 90 plus 30, nothing but 120. That is equal to again. What is the third force? Mg, nothing but 900 Newtons by again how much the opposite angle is? Simply 90 sine 90. Okay, so this is the formula. Means so how much it is? T1 by sin 90 plus theta cos theta plus cos theta. Okay, as for the second quadrant sine function is positive, means how much it is? T by sin 60, which is equal to how much it is? T2 by yes sin 30 degrees is equal to how much it is? 900 by 1. Now by taking the values, like in order to find the values of T1 and T2, we have to equate this first and last term. In order to find the value of T2, we have to equate second and last term, means second and third term. Means by equating the first and last one, T1 by sin 60 is equal to how much? 900.
900.
That means here what is the value of T1 by sin 60 means root 3 by 2. Is equal to how much it is? 900. Therefore T1 is equal to how much? 900 into root 3 by 2. That means how much it is? 450 root 3 Newtons. Okay. Now again, so this is the value of T1, tensile force in the first thing. So as per the concept, we have to equate the second and last term. What is the value here? T2 by again. In order to find the value of T2, we have to equate the second and last term. Means how much it is? T2 by sin 30 is equal to 900. Means T2 by sin 30 means 1 by 2 again. Is equal to how much? 900. Therefore T2 is equal to how much? 450 Newtons. Okay. So this is the method of finding the values of T2 and T1. Okay, by using Lami's theorem. Please note on it. All of you, it is very important model. That means in order to get the values of T1 and T2, we have to apply the Lami's theorem. According to Lami's theorem, what is the formula? Actual formula? If the three forces acting on the particle simultaneously acting on the body, then the body is at rest. That means P by sin alpha is equal to Q by sin beta is equal to R by sin gamma. Means P by sin of opposite angle of P, Q by sin of opposite angle to the Q, R by sin of opposite angle to the R. That means P by sine of opposite angle between the remaining two vectors like alpha, Q by sine of remaining angle between the two vectors means P and R, nothing but beta, R by sine of opposite angle between the remaining vectors means P and Q, nothing but gamma, as per the previous diagram. So this is the actual definition of Lami's theorem. So from this theorem, we have to apply, means we have to take in place of P, I am taking T1 as per our my convenience. So in place of Q, I am taking T2. In place of R, third force is nothing but 900 Newton. Okay. So by taking this values, we have to substitute in this equation, then how much it is? P by sin alpha means how much? What is the opposite angle to the T1 means? Here, this is 90 plus 60, total angle is 150. Again, T2 by sin of opposite angle means how much it is? Total 90 plus 30, sin 90 plus 30. Again, Mg by sin of 90, opposite angle. Okay. So by equating first and last term and second and last term, we got the equations of T1 and T2 here. Yeah, please all of you note it down.
It is very important problem.
I have to explain another example for this Lamy's theorem also, how to apply this Lamy's theorem. Yeah, okay. So, I have to give one problem which is related to the Lamy's theorem again. Again, this Lamy's theorem, nothing but condition for equilibrium. Means equilibrium concept which is discussed again in Newton's laws of motion. Okay. So again, I have to give one more problem based on this Lamy's theorem. Now let us say, from figure. Again, from figure. Find the values of tensions. Find the values of tensions T1 and T2. Now listen carefully what I am giving the diagram. So it is related to simple mathematics. So this is a particle of mass m here. So here 20 newtons. So here what I am taking the first string is like T1 here tension, this is the tension T2 here, what I am giving the angle, let us say here 60 degrees, this is 90 degrees we know already, again this is also 60 degrees, okay. So this is the given problem, that means here what is the, here particle where weight is 20 newtons, means mass is nothing but mass m is equal to how much it is, 2 kg. That means this 2 kg body is a crest under the applications of 3 forces, like that means this 3 kg body which is suspended by means of two strings. Okay, so this is the first string, this is the second string, and the weight of the particle is always downward, means here what is the force acting on the body, tensile force T1 upward, T2 in this direction, and mg downward direction. Now listen carefully how to find the angles like this. That means if you know this, listen carefully, if the value of theta is equal to 60, this is also 60, why? Because both are alternate angles. If it is 60, it is also 60. That means listen carefully. So this total triangle which forms how much angle? 360. This total closed triangle, or this is the closed this value. This means a point which always forms 360 means how much it is? 60 plus 90. How much? 150. 150 plus 60. How much it is? 210. That means you have to take, this is nothing but the 150. So in the closed value, that means in the diagram only I have to take, this is the 150. Yeah, please tell me what is the angle here? Remaining angle. That means if a particle which is placing in a plane, it forms in a closed loop, how much angle? 360. That means this is 50, 60 plus 150, 210. Again, how much angle this is? 150 degrees. Okay, listen carefully. So as per the diagram only I am giving in this way directions, means the angles. So this is 60, this is 90 we know already because these are two perpendicular walls. As per the diagram, here I am giving 60, here I am giving 60, here 150 I am giving. Because in a total triangle, it forms total angle is 360. That's why here I am taking 150. Listen carefully. If it is 60, it is also 60. Then what is the angle? Remaining angle is how much? Because a point which forms on the plane means total 360 degrees in a closed circle. Okay? That's why. Now, according to the Lamy's theorem, what is the formula? Py. Sin alpha is equal to again q by sin beta is equal to again r by sin of gamma. So by taking this equation, we have to apply the values of T1, T2 and mg with corresponding angles. Means how much it is in place of p, I am taking T1 by sin of. Yeah. What is the opposite angle for T1 here? T1 opposite angle sin 60 only. Okay. And what is the opposite angle for T2? T2 by sin of. What is the opposite angle for T2 here? 150. Again, what is the 20? Means R. Means 20 by. What is the opposite angle for 20? Vector sin of again 150. Okay. In order to find the values of T1 and T2 by this expression, we have to equate the first and last term. And the second and last term. That means by equating first and last term means we got the values of T1. Second and last term means you got the value of T2 from this equation. Okay. Now how to find this one? T1 by sin 60 means root 3 by 2. Sin 60 means root 3 by 2. Is equal to how much it is? 20 by again sin 150. Sin 150 means sin of 90 plus 60. Sin of 90 plus 60 means how much it is? Again 20 y can be written as sine of 90 plus 60 cos 60. That means it can be rewritten as p1 by root 3 by 2, which is equal to how much it is? 20 by 1 by 2. Here 1 by 2, 1 by 2 cancel. Means what is the value here? P1 is equal to 20 into root 3 newtons. Means what is the value of T1 here? 20 root 3 newtons. Okay. Now in the same way, by equating second and last term, means T2 by sine of 150, which is equal to how much? 20 by again sine of 150. Both are same terms. So means both are cancelled together. Means what is the value of tension here? 20 newtons. So this is the method to find the tensional forces in the two strings. Means the particle which is suspended by two strings, by the help of two strings here. So here what I am giving in this diagram, let us say these are the two perpendicular walls. Here 90 degrees given, here 60 degrees given, here also 60 degrees given, this is 150 again as from the diagram. Now listen carefully, this is the given diagram. Now I have to find this angle and this angle. Because for example, listen carefully, if it is 60 as per the alternate angles, it is also 60. Okay. Now by taking this, suppose if a point which is placing on the plane, it forms a 360 degrees angle in a closed loop. Means this is 150, this is 60, total 210. What is the remaining angle here? 150. Okay. That means by taking the assumptions, we got the values of 60 and 150. That means each is opposite to T1 is 60 degrees. Opposite to the T2 of what is the angle here? 150. That means as per the Lambert's theorem, P by sin alpha is equal to Q by sin beta is equal to R by sin gamma. Okay. Now we have to substitute the values of in place of P, I am taking T1. In place of Q, I am taking T2. In place of R, I am taking third vector is 20 newtons. Okay. By manipulating in this process, you got the values of T1 and T2. Okay, right. Thank you very much. So these are the relations, these are the problems which is related to Lambert's theorem. Thank you. Thank you very much.